Hey guys, we just got back from the unbearable weight of massive talent from our personal friend, Nicolas Cage. Guys, this is such a fucking feel-good, awesome comedy, buddy story, bromance, slash meta piece, character-driven piece for Nicolas Cage. Man, I just fucking love Nicolas Cage. Now, get this. I'm fucking biased already, all right? I watch Nick's good stuff. I watch his really bad stuff.
What's bad stuff?
Oh, there's one where he's like a fucking cop where he's sleepwalking through it just nonstop.
Oh, no, no. That was an like instant classic. Fucking, I don't even know what you're talking about. It's amazing.
God, I can't even remember. It's like 977. It's just, there's some really bad shit on Amazon. Because I convinced myself I am going to watch every single Nicolas Cage film. I didn't get through them all. That's how bad it was. But he does often pick some good projects, and this was tailor-made for him, obviously.
Yes.
So many in-jokes about Con Air and fucking Face Off and all of his classics. And I was like, please mention Mandy. Please mention Mandy. Mandy, we got to mention, you know? So I just fucking loved it. You could tell everybody was having a great time. This is a genuinely funny film with sequences that made me laugh out loud to where I had tears in my eyes. And I'm like, man, all right, it's good to know.
It's been a long time since I've laughed like that, and this was, yeah. I love this one.
That happens during an LSD-fueled cageness part. We won't ruin it for you, but I really highly, highly recommend, if you like Nicolas Cage, if you like bro stories and just the art and the craft of filmmaking and stuff like that, that this is one that you should go out and see in theaters. We saw two good films today, Northmen. Go check out a review for that, The Northmen, and The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent. It's good to have good content coming out while we just finished watching some really shitty TV show stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
so this is the one that I recommend, even over Northmen. I enjoyed this one a lot. What did you guys think?
This is a must-go-see now.
Yeah.
I loved it. I like how he was poking humor, like fun of it himself, too.
Oh,
like,
right, yeah.
I'm a hardworking man. Like, oh, Nick, you're making too many movies. It's like, I'm just working. It's like, how is that a downfall, making so
right.
many movies?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
It's like, I got bills to pay.
To pay family to feed.
I love that. A
lot of in jokes.
Joking himself.
Apparently, he had an AMA on Reddit that was like the most popular AMA. I haven't read it yet, but you hear it was great.
Oh, it was super
More
great,
comments
yeah.
than Obama when he did his. So, a really cool guy.
I need to check that out, too.
Yeah.
I also liked his inner monologue as younger Nick. Mm-hmm. How they talk to each
oh
other.
Oh my God!
That
yes,
is another banger.
Great part.
Nicholas Coppola is talking to
it him. Is literally the cageness, the cage moments from all those films is bundled into his fucking baggage and his persona. It's perfect. The film is meta in good ways in a lot of different sections, and that is
the
a really
chemistry
good one.
Between him and Pedro. Fucking amazing. Oh,
fucking
I loved it.
Yes.
I could tell there's more chemistry between this than Northmen, the love.
The love story? Yeah. Pedro Pascal, such a good fucking actor, dude. His fucking smile lights up the room. All right. Well, what do you think, Alex?
I really liked it. I think meta is really, really hard to do. We've seen a lot of meta movies, meta TV shows that just fucking fail because you really have to know what you're doing. Like, everyone kind of has to be in on it, and like, you're kind of laughing with and at them.
Yes.
And I think they absolutely nailed it here. I love the chemistry between the two. I think the story was clever enough for what this is trying to do. Like, this isn't like...
No.
This isn't like craziness, but I mean, yeah. like as far as like the plot goes,
that doesn't really make sense, and they probably wouldn't do that. But there's kind of an excuse for it later on in the film.
Yeah, mm-hmm. and I just it's super fun. I think that even if you're not a huge fan of Nicolas Cage, like all of his other ones, you don't need to have watched all of them. Oh, you should because Face Off and
yeah,
the Rock.
There were
classics.
Yeah.
Right, go fucking watch them.
Well, there was a few films that Nicolas Cage mentioned that I had not seen that he liked. So I have to go and watch these films. I forgot exactly which one. I'll have to look them up. But ones that he found. Because they were talking about, oh, what's your best favorite movies? And the guy's number one movie is Face Off. He's like, really? Are you serious? It makes sense if he's such a big fan of him that he wants him to show up at his fucking birthday party, right? So, yeah, just really, really fun. I mean, these two carry the film. This whole BFF stuff is just fantastic. It's great. Yeah, I really liked it. So what else could I say? So they got a greater plot where it's they're trying to do. Go ahead and take it with the CIA stuff here that was in the trailer.
Yeah, there's a secret mission. He's a drug cartel.
Yeah,
gunrunners.
Makes sense.
Like, hey, we need. He's got something that we need. We need you to find some intel. So try to go around his house and plant some cameras, and find see what you can find out.
Yeah.
He does this mission terribly, which is hilarious.
Very good.
Which I just fucking loved.
This would never happen. The U.S. government hires Nicolas Cage to do it. And he's actually doing it, and he's doing some of the spy shit, right? Yeah, terribly. Very terribly.
Just trying to see what else we could say without spoiling.
Yeah, I mean, the trailers kind of gave away that the government are looking at Pedro Pascal because he may be a piece of shit. Mm-hmm. And then so there's the internal conflict. He's like, well, it turns out that, he's a great guy, and maybe he's a gun runner, maybe all these other things have happened. And then so the story just kind of unfolds, and we just get a wonderful, like, unlikely buddy movie where they're like bonding and they're doing fun stuff and everyone's having a great time. But then every now and then the CIA are like, hey, like, go break into that room and see what it is. And it's like, oh, man, it's the room from the, I'm not going to spoil what. But there's, like, crazy stuff that happens. So,
yeah,
it's a good time. And if you've got, if you're going to see something this weekend, I think you should see
that's
that one.
That's a must.
Yeah, and so obviously just getting to see an actor kind of behind the scenes doing his thing is interesting. They bring his family into it. It's obviously not Nicolas Cage, like, real family.
No, it's Kate Beckinsale and Martin Sheen's daughter.
Is that who it is? Man, she looks so much like Daisy Ridley. I couldn't stop seeing, like, fucking Rey from Star Wars, just a younger version of Rey from Star Wars there. I was like, that is not his daughter. That is not his wife.
Isn't his son named Kal-El?
Yes. Yeah. I gave him that idea. I'll come out and say it. I said, Nick, we're such best friends. We love Superman together. You should fuck it. Just name your son Kal-El. It's fucking awesome. So he did it, and he's got his son. So, it was just a great fucking time. Let's give it some final verdicts then.
9-10 category.
Yeah, it's tough.
9-10.
Just a great fucking comedy that made me laugh out loud.
Yeah, like this is like I came out of that movie theater. I was like, man, I wanted to see that again. Mm-hmm. I haven't laughed like that in a while. This was actually entertaining all the way through.
All the way through. Never fucking drags. It's always interesting to see these guys.
Fuck it. Let's go with the 10.
They fight, they fight each other with fucking Nicolas Cage fucking
being Nicolas Cage. Talking to Nicolas Cage. Come on.
Using props from the action movies, Nicolas Cage. I mean, it's great. I'm fucking happy to see it, Joe.
Yeah, I'm up in that range too. It was really, really good. It's an absolutely amazing comedy that you should see. I don't know if I can give it a 10 out of 10. No, I mean one. I don't think it's like one. It's very funny.
Yeah,
but I don't think it's like legendary comedy. It's like legendary Nick Cage movie.
If you're a Nick Cage fan, this is legendary.
Yeah, it's up there. I'm gonna go with a 9. I think this is an absolutely great movie that you should go see. It falls a little short from being like fucking legendary. Mm-hmm. Movie.
Yeah, a simplistic plot. The CIA stuff kind of goes. Wait, what?
Just goes away.
Okay, it kind of goes away, and then you're like, okay, and then it kind of. I don't want to ruin anything, so we'll talk about that in spoilers. But you are kind of confused a little bit. Okay, so how did that end or whatever? But it's just a feel good movie, and these two carry the entire film. It's always entertaining. It's motherfucking Nicolas Cage, and he's so meta, and he's so okay with just making fun of himself, and it's just fucking fantastic. And the CGI is surprisingly good on young Cage. Like he's like really, and I'm curious. It's like, is he playing himself, and then they just CGI it, or do they use a stand-in and put the CGI face on him? I think he probably stood in for himself.
Yeah, he used the de-aging stuff, probably.
Yeah, so it's fucking great, guys. Go see this. If you're a Nicolas Cage fan, even if you're not a Nicolas Cage fan.
How dare you.
If you're into the BFF kind of comedy films and stuff, it's a good one. So we highly recommend it. Go check it out. We'll talk a little spoilers here for those of you who have already seen it. Good on you, because I want the film to do well. I want the man to have an excellent blockbuster, and he already has. He's had many blockbusters, but just I like the guy. So anyways, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the spoilers section.
Yeah, what'd you give it?
What'd you give it?
I fucking forgot it. So this is a lot of content today that we did. I am going to give it. I can totally see. I'm in 9, 10. I'm gonna go with 9. I love it. I think there are other Nicolas Cage films that I like. This one just honors the man. I still like Mandy best. Mandy is one of my favorites.
Spoilers.
9 out of 10. All right, guys. So we'll see you guys in the spoiler section. Bye, guys. Hey guys, welcome to the spoiler section. So obviously, Pedro Pascal is, this cartel guy. But later on in the film, it is revealed that it's not really him. It's his...
he's the face of the operation.
He's the face of the operation.
It's his cousin, yes.
Cousin. Cousin actually is a good actor, too. I like the fact that he's so villainous and he's all, a little over the top. And he basically says, we found out your American friend that you fucking love so much betrayed you. So I'm going to kill you if you don't kill him. And then the American government, for no apparent reason, is like, we allow you to murder this person, commit murder. Nicolas Cage, go kill him before he kills you. So the CIA stuff doesn't really work in the film. And so then they have this scene where it's like they're simultaneously supposed to kill each other, but they've had so much fun together on this little trip that he did.
It's like, I love you.
And it's like, I don't want to kill you, man. I love you.
They traded shoes.
And then they say, fuck it.
We'll all lie together. Look, if you want to see old Nick Cage make out, really make out with young Nicolas Cage, you got to see this movie.
Nicolas Cage gives great smooches, remember?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So many good lines. When they're first kind of, hanging out, they do LSD together and it fucks them up. And they come up with the crazy ideas for the fucking script and making a movie together. And escaping, they look at these two guys eating ice cream. They're like, oh shit, are they looking over here? I don't know. No. Oh shit, I think they are looking over here. And they get all paranoid. They start to run away from him. There's this big wall. And it's like, oh fuck, use my back. And Pedro Pascal. And so Nick uses his back and gets up and he tries to lift him up. But he's not strong enough. So he's like, go without me. No, I don't want. And they do the whole. Movie trope.
Being dramatic.
It was
so
great.
They're on acid. It's fine. It was great.
It's great. Such a fucking strong scene. And so you buy their friendship by the time it comes around where you kill each other, and then they realize, no, we don't want to kill each other. We want to be friends and sort of, team up. Mm-hmm. So that's what they do. And go ahead.
It spirals a little out of control towards the end. They do this bit with they put Nick Cage in makeup and they try to pretend him, and it's still
it's
very
Sergio.
Fun. I was like, I'd already swallowed the hook for this movie by that time. But if you're not having a good time, you're probably not gonna like it. But
his wife
comes
up like, I'm a good prosthetic artist.
Yeah,
so
we're gonna turn you into this cartel boss, and it's just kind of
you're gonna clearly
goofy.
See it's Nick Cage.
Yeah, and it's real.
I loved it when he went in there and the fucking bad guy grabbed him immediately. You stupid fucking idiot. You think that I wouldn't know? But then
he doesn't know.
He just thought it was like, how dare you show up, with all
great.
This time.
Come on.
Right. That's why you forgive it, because you're already having such a fucking great time.
The suspension of disbelief is super important when we're watching things. And a lot of people criticize, like, wow, you guys are just like, you guys are cynical. It's like, well, the problem is there's times when the writing is so bad periodically and stuff that we review where it sucks you out.
Yes.
And once you're out and you see something that's kind of weird, or it's like it could be funny, but you're not in the mood for it anymore. This movie, I never felt that at all. Even with how kind of hokey and kind of crazy it is, I never once got sucked out of this movie. Yep. They did a really, really good job making you believe that all of this stuff sort of could possibly happen, and you just have you're having such a good time, it doesn't matter.
It's been script talked to the point where even when I'm coming through it, I'm like, you know, it would be funny. It's like, why don't you like, you know, there's a car chase, and it's like, hey, slamming the brakes is a good move. It's like, yeah, it works in the films. Let's try it. So they try it. The dude falls into the back, and he's like, yeah, we knocked him out. And he gets punched because the dude's not knocked out, and they have to knock him out later on. So it's like, you know, fun stuff like that. And that's all throughout the film.
Yeah, and then obviously the main premise is one of the candidates' daughters got kidnapped.
The presidential election in Spain is happening.
That was the main plot. They're hiding the daughter somewhere
and
in the compound.
So the cartel captures the daughter.
Nicolas Cage has to find out where she's being held.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the whole thing. And so, you know, Pedro Pascal's character finds that out, finally decides to stand up to his brother. He's like, go. And he gives him a last stand. He's like, don't worry. You get out of here with your family, because he brought his family there to have a therapy session with his daughter. And a lot of
misunderstandings.
Yeah. And the therapy session was working, but they had to cut it short because they're going to go on this adventure. And so he does this last stand where he's like shooting all his guns at his brother's. Doesn't really stop him, but he tried. And how did they eventually win against this cartel guy?
Well, they don't. They crash into the embassy, and the cartel guy grabs Nicolas Cage. But earlier, they had shown you a knife fell out of the pocket of the bad guy.
They kept showing that fucking knife three times.
So the daughter grabs the knife and throws it at her dad, who snatches it out of the air and then kills the dude.
Nick Cage style.
But we don't actually see it happen because it cuts away, and we actually see the actual movie. They pull a Tropic Thunder, the same kind of thing.
So that makes you wonder, well, how much of it was embellished and how much of it was real, that can retroactively excuse some of the shit. I am assuming that it's all in at least in this world, it all happened up until that.
Demi Moore is his wife at the ex wife at the end. Demi Moore is there, everything actually happened, and then when she shows up, movie magic.
Right. So.
It's great.
It's fucking wonderful. It's a great story. So, guys, we have nothing but good things to say. Mm-hmm. Let's make this one short. It's fucking awesome. Go out and see it.
So
I do want to mention Tiffany Haddish is in it, and there's another guy. Yeah, there's two CIA agents. She's a part of the CIA agents, and they see Nicolas Cage. They're like, what the fuck? I was like, who is this? And they keep coming up with these movies. So they have these jokes. It's like, what is the most famous movie? Oh, from Croods 2? And it's like, what? That's the fucking movie you would mention with Nicolas Cage?
The only one they're talking about was Moonstruck.
Moonstruck.
That's the one that you said you haven't
then
seen.
No, it was another one. Some avant-garde film.
Oh, yeah. They're like, oh, it's a 100-year-old German film.
Yeah, that's the one I was wanting to look up. And then they're talking about Paddington 2, which, by the way, I have seen Paddington 2. It is fucking...
It is a tearjerker.
It's probably not as good as they're saying, but it is a tearjerker. But anyways, so there's lots of really good jokes in here. It works very well, and... I'm sure Nicolas Cage had a ton of fun filming it. Wait, you want me to do a movie about what?
About me?
About me being like this sort of insecure, insecure fading star? Excuse me, what? No, Nicolas Cage knows how to pick his projects.
It's good.
Does he?
Sometimes.
Does he? Like that's a
never
weird.
Mind.
Yeah,
it's never like, mind. Because there's a few of them that aren't that aren't the best. But every once in a while he'll hit a badass one, and this is one of those. So, anyways,
it's good to be back. It's like I was never gone.
Yeah,
and remember, I was ever gone his thing that he says. And no, Nicolas Cage, you were never gone. I will always love you as an actor and keep watching his movies. So more like this. All right, guys, thank y'all so much for watching. Go out and see it and support Nicolas Cage in this film. I think you'll like it. All right, we'll see you on the next Angry Joe Show. Bye, guys.